Hi guys, welcome back to another hair product review on this channel and thanks so much for tuning in again. Now in today's video, I'm gonna talk about the brand... I'm gonna talk about the brand EVO, which is an Australian hair care brand. I'm going to talk about four of their products, one being on the floor, but they are very good and I do really enjoy them. And they have kind of a similarity, or at least some of the products have similarities to the brand Kevin Murphy. But before I do that, let me quickly say I'm very, very sorry for the long time that I haven't been uploading on this channel. I think it's about 2 to 3 months that I haven't posted anything. And you guys probably think I'm dead, but I'm actually still alive and my beard obviously still is there. So everything's good, but I just had a lot of work to do. And there was some busy times. So I'm very sorry. I have 3 videos in the pipeline for the coming weeks. So I hope I will be able to shoot more videos in that time to keep the wheel running. But yeah, luckily you are still there. I recently discovered this brand on a hairdresser and hairstyling convention in Germany. And I believe they are almost exclusively sold in hair salons. So physical salons, because there is only one online shop in Germany that is allowed to sell them online. And except for this one, there is no other shop that sells them. And they are exclusively sold in hair salons, of course. So I picked up 4 of their products. And first I would like to give you a very quick rundown of the general styling and packaging and scent options that are available. I think the packaging itself is very creative. I think this has never been seen before and it's very, very crazy. Many Australian hair care brands do crazy shit. So Kevin Murphy being one of them and EVO another one of them. But something that I didn't really get is the text that is on the products. I mean, they have their names, so styling clay, texture paste, molding whip, which is weird, and construction cream. So they tell you what the product does, but then there is this text that is printed on each of the products. For example, a text like, tells you what you want to hear. Perfect for the friendless and those who need to spend a lot on jeans. In brackets, see placebo in the dictionary. So there is the occasional what the fuck moment when reading these, and I don't really know what they're supposed to tell me. Maybe it's a movie quote or something. I don't really know. I'm not that deep into it. But apart from that, I enjoy the packaging. I mean, it's a very nice packaging. It seems a little flimsy sometimes, but I enjoy it overall. And I really appreciate that for each of these products, it tells you what the hold and shine factor will be like on the back of the product. In terms of scent, I have to say they are mostly unscented products. So they have only a very weak scent. For example, this styling clay has, I believe, one of the stronger type scents. And it goes hand in hand with what you know from brands like Kevin Murphy, for example. So this is, for example, a tonka bean vanilla type scent, kind of earthy, but very, very faint, which is something that is good, I believe. I mean, there are strong hairstyling products that smell amazing, but these ones are very, very weakly scented. So Matt from TDM Style.
Oh, dude, fuck me up.
You should check them out because they smell amazing, but you won't have too long of them. So yeah. So the first one is probably my favorite one of these. It's the Cassius Styling Clay. This is a product that I've seen before on the channel of Robin James, but I haven't seen any review of these products yet. So I'm very happy to present them to you here. This styling clay looks kind of wonky, I have to say. I'm going to put a close-up on the screen right now. Wonky because it actually has a very, very thin greenish layer on top of the actual product. But overall, this clay is quite similar to Kevin Murphy's Rough Rider, probably also because it contains diatomaceous earth as well, which is an oil-absorbing ingredient that will make your hairstyle very matte, even if you haven't shampooed for like 2 days or so. So overall, this clay has a very nice gritty texture. If you have loved Rough Rider, you are going to love this as well. But for me, it's actually the perfect bridge between something like Rough Rider and something like Cavalier or Claymation, because it doesn't have that fine strand separation issue that I probably already told you about in my Rough Rider video. And if you haven't seen that, please check out the info button right here. So this one is a really good intermediate product between a very gritty and dry clay like Rough Rider and more of a traditional heavy clay like Claymation and Cavalier. And I really, really enjoyed using it. It's a dream to work with. It gives you tremendous volume, absolutely crazy volume. And the finish is also really, really nice. So I used quite a bit of it. I'm probably going to use it until the very end, which doesn't happen too often. And it really gives Cavalier a hard time in my bathroom. Next up is Boxer Bollocks, which is a texture paste with a supposed 1 out of 5 shine factor and a 5 out of 5 hold factor. I've also seen this on Robin James's channel, so this probably means that this works for thin hair as well. But for my thick hair, it works quite okay. It's not the best matte paste that I've used, but it's really quite good. But I have to say that I do not agree. I absolutely do not agree with the 1 out of 5 shine factor. Because it gives me more of a natural shine, natural finish, and not a totally matte finish. And it really depends on how I prepped my hair, which is something that I oftentimes see with matte pastes or with texture pastes, which is that they enhance the shine level of your hair. So this means that if you naturally have matte hair or have dry hair, even as a hair condition, a matte paste or a texturizing paste will give you a very, very matte finish. And on the other hand, if you have a slight shine or you've applied a hair oil or it's your second day hair, then it will give you more of a natural type finish. And it's the same with this one. So I cannot totally agree on the 1 out of 5 shine level. I would probably give it a 2 to maybe even 3 out of 5. The hold factor is also not totally accurate. I mean, it really depends on your hair type. For me, it's more of a 4 out of 5, sorry. And for someone with finer hair, it will probably be more of a 5 out of 5. So before I talk about another one of my favorite products from this brand, I'm going to quickly touch on this one, which is Casual Act, and it's called a molding whip, which is something that I haven't ever seen before, but it's exactly what is inside this box. So first of all, this product should have a 2 out of 5 hold factor and a 2 out of 5 shine factor, which compared to the texture paste, it's not something that I can agree on. I would say that this time the shine factor is maybe a little bit less shiny than it says on the packaging, because this will give you a very, very natural finish. But the most interesting thing about this one is actually its consistency, because as you can see, it's exactly like whip. So it's exactly like whipped cream or a very, very light lotion. It's very spongy and very, very airy and fluffy. And it's really funny to use because you can use loads of it. And depending on how much you use, you will get more of a shine and more of a finish in general, or less of a shine and less of a finish. And actually, if you use very little of this product, it will still give you an effect, but you will not notice that there is anything in your hair. So this is really predestined to be a pre-styling product. And if you use very little, you will get more of a hair mousse or sea salt spray type finish, but without the nasty crunch that oftentimes comes with these products. And if you use more of it, it will be noticeable after blow drying. So you will see a finish, you will see texture and all that stuff. And you can really layer this product. But on the other hand, I have to say, I haven't really gotten around to using it that much. And the effects are not as consistent as I would like to have them for my regular daily pre-styler. And the last one is Crop Stutters Construction Cream, which is another one of my favorites. It's like a mixture of Styling Meraki by Blumann and Monarch Matte Paste by Blumann. If you ever tried Monarch in damp hair as a pre-styler, you know what I'm talking about. The difference between Meraki and Monarch is the finish and the amount of control that you get. And with this one, you get the exact in between. So you get more of a wet type finish compared to Meraki. It's more of a texturized finish. It also gives you a little bit more control even. And therefore, in my opinion, it's an excellent pre-styler if you, for example, want to finish it off with a type of clay. So this works, for example, amazingly well with Cassius styling clay, because Cassius is more of a dry type product. This one gives you more of a shine as a pre-styler, and in combination they work really well and they hold all day, give you loads of texture and an amazing finish. Apart from that, the consistency is thick and creamy, which is good for a pre-styler because you want to feel where you have put pre-styler in your hair and where you haven't. Basically, everything about this product is awesome and I really like to use it. So, as a conclusion, we have two clear winners, which is Casio Styling Clay and Crop Starters Construction Cream. So if you can get past the wobbly packaging, I can totally recommend these two products to you, but the other ones are also really quite good. And overall, I can say that I haven't encountered a product by EVO that hasn't worked like at least a little bit for me. And although I can't agree on the hold and shine description for all of the products, I really enjoy the brand. So if you want to check out this brand, I will link everything in the description box down below. If you enjoyed this video, please leave me a thumbs up, please subscribe. And I promise I will publish a video next week and the week after, and I will try to publish the week after. Would love to hear your feedback on the brand and on my videos and everything. So please drop a comment in the comment section down below, and I will see you guys next time. So thanks for watching and bye bye.